Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss about some basics and the fundamentals regarding hypothesis testing, and in upcoming videos we will solve some statistical problems related to hypothesis testing. So what is hypothesis testing? It is a statistical technique to test some hypothesis regarding the parent population from which the sample is drawn. Here two special terms are coming, one is sample and second one is population. So what is population and what is sample? Population means the complete collection of all elements which has to be studied, and the sample means a sub collection of the elements drawn from the population. So here first I will write these key points, then I will explain in detail about sample and population. So this is simplified definition of population and a sample. For better understanding, here I am taking one example. For example, one class which is B form first year contains 100 students, and we are determining how many students are watching YouTube videos. And if we are running that estimation in all 100 students, then all 100 students will be considered as population. And if we are running that estimation in 50 students or 20 students out of those 100 students, then those 50 or 20 students will be considered as sample for that class which is B form first year. Now we are taking another example. In this condition, we are taking B form entire course as a population, means B form first year, second year, third year and fourth year will be considered. So total 400 students will be there. And in this case, 400 students will be considered as population. And if we are estimating in all 400 students, then that will be known as population. And if we are taking 20 students from first year, 20 students from second year, 20 students from third year, and 20 students from fourth year, means total 80 students from total B form course, then those 80 students will be considered as sample for that B form course. So sample will always be a representative data for the population. Now coming to the another term which can be used in hypothesis, that is estimation. So what is estimation? Estimation is to use the statistics obtained from the sample as estimate of the unknown parameter of the population from which the sample is drawn. It means sample will be drawn from the population and that sample will be used to estimate the unknown parameter of that population, and that sample will be representative of that population. Now in more refined way, hypothesis testing can be defined as a hypothesis in statistics is simply a quantitative statement about population. Now coming to the procedure for testing the hypothesis. So it is divided into five steps. First one is to set up the hypothesis. Second step is to set the suitable significant level. Third step is to set the test criterion. Fourth step is computation. And the fifth step is making the decisions. So coming to the first step, that is to set up the hypothesis. So there is two type of hypothesis. First one is null hypothesis, which is denoted by H0 or H0. Second one is alternative hypothesis, which is denoted by HA, or sometimes it can be denoted by H1. So coming to the first one, which is H0 or null hypothesis. What is the meaning of null? Null means invalid, void, or amounting to nothing. It means there is no real difference between sample and the population in the particular matter under consideration. So if null hypothesis will be passed, then null hypothesis will be accepted and alternative hypothesis will be rejected. And if null hypothesis will be failed, then null hypothesis will be rejected and alternative hypothesis will be accepted. Now coming to the second point, which is set up a suitable significant level. So in the second step, test of validity of null hypothesis, which is H0, against alternative hypothesis, which is HA, takes place at certain level of significant. This significant level is denoted in terms of percentage. Sometimes it is denoted by alpha, and this percentage may be 5%, maybe 1%, maybe 0.1%, etc. For better understanding of this significant level, first I will draw some illustrations. So in this illustration, you can see that this is 0. Half is present here, half is present here. Means 50% will be coming here, 50% will be coming here. And if we are taking 5% level of significant, means there will be chances of 5% error, 2.5% in left side and 2.5% in right side if it is a two-tailed test. Now what is the meaning of this 5% level of significant? It means we are taking wrong decision 5% times and we are taking right decision 95% times. It means we are taking the risk of 5%, means on every 100 occasions we can make 5 wrong decisions. So if we will take 1% level of significant, in that case our decision will be 1% wrong. So in this case, this is two-tailed test, means 2.5% decision may be wrong in left side and 2.5% decision may be wrong in right side. That is why it is known as two-tailed test. But there is one-tailed test also. One-tailed test is of two types. One is left-sided and second one is right-sided, like this. So this is one tail test and it is left sided one tail test. So error will occur only in the left side. This is two tail test. So error may occur in both the sided. 50% chances of left side and 50% chances of right side. That is why 5% is divided into two part. 2.5% in this side, 2.5% is this side. Now coming to the third one, which is one tail test and it is right sided. It means error will occur only in the right side. Now coming to the critical Z value for this hypothesis testing, and those Z values are fixed for one tail test and two tail test, and it will be like this. So these are the critical Z value. This one is level of significance, that is 10%, 5%, 1% and 0.1%. For one tilde, it is 1.65, 1.96, 2.58, 3.29. For two tailed test, it is 1.28, 1.64, 2.33 and 3.10. And what is Z value? It is a standardized score that describes how many standard deviations an element is from the mean. For example, we are taking this is the mean, then from here to here, how many standard deviation will be covered? If we are taking 5% level of significance, then this will cover 1.96. It means if we are performing any two-tailed test, then our calculated Z value should be between minus 1.96 to plus 1.96. So that value will come within this range and that null hypothesis will be passed and it will be accepted. In other cases, null hypothesis will be failed and it will be rejected. So ultimately we can say that if we are taking 5% level of significance, then it is 1.96 time of standard deviation. Now coming to the third step, which is setting a test criterion. So in this step, selection of appropriate probability distribution takes place and some probability distributions are students t-test, chi-square test, Fisher's f-test, etc. Now coming to the fourth step, which is doing computation. So in this computation step, all calculation will be done after selecting the statistical method. And the last step is making decision. So in this step, we have to draw the statistical conclusions and we have to take the decisions. And during this decision taking, either we have to accept the null hypothesis or we have to reject the null hypothesis. If we are accepting the null hypothesis, then we have to reject the alternative hypothesis. If we are rejecting null hypothesis, then we have to accept the alternative hypothesis. And during this decision making, two types of error may occur like this. So if we are accepting H0 means we are accepting null hypothesis, then automatically we are rejecting HA. And if we are rejecting H0, it means automatically we are accepting HA. So as per our analysis, if HA means null hypothesis is true, and if we are accepting HA, then our decision is correct. And if HA is true and we are rejecting HA or accepting alternative hypothesis, then it will give type 1 error. And if our null hypothesis is false and if we are accepting null hypothesis, then it will give type 2 error. And if our null hypothesis is false and if we are rejecting this null hypothesis, then our decision is correct. So in this step, we have to take the decisions very carefully, otherwise this type of errors may occur during the analysis. Now in next video, we will solve some statistical problems related to this hypothesis testing. Thank you.